All right, weather-wise, we're dealing with mainly dry conditions across most of Northeast Ohio, but you know what's staring us in the face out towards the west. Whenever you see a radar and it has the reds and the greens and all that stuff and the really bright colors in here, that doesn't tell you that it's a severe storm. It tells you that you've got really heavy rain, and that's exactly what we're dealing with right now. Sandusky locked in right now. We've got heavy rain right over Cedar Point, some lightning strikes with that. That extends south into areas of Erie County. Now getting into Huron County, the northern tip of it now near Norwalk. You can hear the rumbles off towards your north, but this is heavy rain that's going over the same area over and over. So back towards Seneca County, we do have flood advisories. I would imagine in Sandusky and areas of Erie County, we'll probably get into some kind of flood advisory as well. Rainfall rates with this anywhere from 1 inch to about 1.5 inches per hour. So it's coming down really good. This is eventually going to creep along the lakeshore. It may affect areas of coastal Lorain County, but the rest of us will stay dry for a little bit as we're going to try to thread the needle for the Guardians game here coming up at 7:10. This rain is going to be just offshore. They haven't made a decision on that, but we'll try to aid in helping that. Out towards the west, though, you notice we've got more activity coming in from the Cincinnati area. This is about 3 hours out. We've got some activity as you get down towards the Dayton area, and then this is going to move in tomorrow morning. This is a little swirling area of low pressure that will continue to provide that uplift in the atmosphere. So bottom line, we're going to crank out some rain tonight across a good deal of Northeast Ohio. Some of that could be heavy at times. The frontal boundary is kind of a complicated one. It stretches all the way up towards the Dakotas. This will eventually sag south during the day tomorrow. It's not until it passes, which is likely in the afternoon, that we can clear us out from the rainfall chances, as we'll have scattered rain and rumbles around during the daytime tomorrow as well. Temperatures where we haven't had the rain, we're up near 80. Boy, is it muggy. We've cooled down out towards the west with that rain-cooled air, but we measure that muggy with something we call the dew point. When this gets at 60 or above, you can feel the air. You start to sweat as you head outside. We've had some dew points, especially down in areas of Tuscarawas, Carroll counties. I've been up in the upper 60s today. That's Floridian type humidity around, and that humidity is going to aid in these shower and thunderstorms to continue tonight. Nothing severe. We may have some strong gusty winds at times, but this isn't a big severe threat. It's a heavy rain threat tonight, and we could use it. Area lawns and gardens could certainly use the rain, and we are going to get it. National Design Mart Hour by our forecast kind of takes that initial line and fades it out over the lake. And then as we go through time tonight, remember that swirl I showed you, that will swirl its way through Northeast Ohio, likely moderate to heavy rain at times during the overnight. Maybe woken up by a rumble of thunder or two, but it doesn't look to be anything in terms of a lot of lightning and thunder, just a lot of rain with that. Tomorrow we start you out. We'll likely have rain exiting. We'll have scattered showers as we go throughout the morning and midday tomorrow, so not a washout. You notice the sun peaks in there as well. As we get into the afternoon, here comes that frontal boundary across the lake. That will likely kick off additional showers and thunderstorms that will move from north to south. Once that line gets out of here tomorrow afternoon, we'll be in the clear, and that's some good news. We'll bring in drier air, and look at this. We really dry things out, and we cool things down heading into Wednesday morning. Temperatures in the 50s, so a little bit more refreshing. Rainfall does not fall evenly in thunderstorms ever, so you notice the hodgepodge numbers here. Don't pay attention to the number on your town. Pay attention to the trend. We could see up over 1 inch, maybe 2 inches if we get that training or that long-lasting rain from some of these thunderstorms. But there is some breath of fresh air coming in. Midweek, we turn a little bit more comfortable, and on to the weekend, you think we'd be dry with that more comfortable air, but that's not going to be the case. Pretty active pattern this week. We kind of thread the needle here on Wednesday with some late-day rain. Another system comes at it this weekend as this very active pattern continues. In terms of rainfall, that bottom number is the one you want to look at, though. We do have a surplus on the year so far, so all this rain is going to be great. Union Home Mortgage 7-day forecast. We dance around in the 70s this week with rainfall chances as we get it into Friday and Saturday. And the weekend right now, some rain, but it will be cooler around here. Russ?
All right, Matt. Thanks a lot.